Hello and welcome to Understanding Under 5 Market Research Concepts in less than 5 minutes. Today, I will talk about a very useful market research technique called conjoint analysis. Conjoint analysis is one of the most powerful methodologies in optimizing product features. It's especially useful for decisions when limited resources only permit a handful of product features to be included in a product, and the company needs to decide which features to prioritize. Because of this, conjoint analysis is often referred to as trade-off analysis. It's lesser known that conjoint analysis is also very effective when looking to understand a product's price elasticity, in finding the most optimal price point, in understanding what customers are willing to pay for a new service or a new feature in a product, in forecasting a new product's demand, and in understanding how valuable a brand name is. So let's take a deeper dive on how conjoint analysis works. Conjoint analysis is a survey-based research technique. The data which is used for the conjoint analysis comes from an exercise done by survey takers called the choice task. This here is a choice task example in which survey takers are asked to compare 3 credit cards. They're given relevant information about the 3 cards, what brands issue the card, what type of card it is, whether there is an annual fee, if yes, how much, whether you have cash back, and many other relevant attributes. When survey takers reviewed these, they select the one they'd prefer, and then a set of new credit cards are shown, again, with all the information. And it goes on and on. Each survey taker makes about 8 to 10 choices. So how does the choice task exercise allow us to calculate price elasticity, optimize product features, forecast demand, and the many fantastic business answers we get from conjoint analysis? How can we do all of that from simply having people pick from options? Well, here's how it works. Let's suppose the product we want to analyze and the products in the category have 3 main important attributes. It may be its brand, package size, and price. For illustration, we'll call them triangle, square, and circle. And each attribute can have different levels, just like brand can be different brands, size can be of different sizes. And let's just say our shapes can be of different colors. These colors represent the different levels of the attributes. In the choice task, a survey taker is shown 3 products side by side. And while the survey taker thinks she is shown 3 different products, for the purposes of the conjoint analysis, it's really just almost random combinations of the 3 shapes, colors, shown 3 times side by side. Because conjoint analysis is a probabilistic methodology, after hundreds of people making altogether thousands of choices among the different combinations of the colors of the various shapes, the analysis will look for patterns in those thousands of choices. It will look at patterns on which color in each shape makes it more or less likely for survey takers to select a product when it is shown. In fact, it will calculate a score for each shape's color, indicating whether that color increases or decreases the probability that the product will be selected. This score is called Partworth Utility Score. In our example of shapes and colors, among the shape of triangle, for example, it looked like green was the most appealing. Conjoint analysis calculated a utility score of 1.52, followed by yellow, then blue, and then orange. That means in the choice task, the product in which the triangle was green tended to be selected by survey takers more than when it was yellow and quite a bit more than when it was blue or orange. Now, if we make the assumption that the total appeal of a product is the sum of appeals of its parts, then we can construct any product from these shapes and colors, and then we can sum up these Partworth utilities to get the total utility of that product. Think about it as its total appeal. And we can use a statistical formula and estimate how much more or less likely that particular product would be to be selected by customers than other products it may be competing against. This is called preference share, and by calculating preference share, we can estimate potential demand for a new product launch. The Partworth utility scores can also be used to calculate an optimal product. We can construct a product simply by selecting the colors from each shape that maximize probability of selecting that product in the market. In other words, the optimal product. Now, for example, if one of the shapes were price, the Partworth utilities could simply be used to understand the product's price elasticity or its demand curve. conjoint analysis is an extremely useful market research technique, and I've not even scratched the surface on all that's possible. For example, it can be used to segment your customer base. But more on that in another video. If you like this video, please hit like and don't forget to subscribe. That way you won't miss future Understand in Under 5 videos. See ya!